Grace to you and peace from God, our Father, and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. For several months now, I've had the privilege of accompanying my daughter Leah on her search for a college to attend in the fall. And many wonderful things have happened through those experiences. And it is almost always the case when you visit a school, you will go into a lecture hall or a concert hall and you will hear presentations from members of the administration and the faculty. They'll talk about the benefit of education in general and the value of the education that their school has to offer in particular. Well, last weekend, we were at the State University of New York at Potsdam. We were there for Accepted Students Day, and we were in this large lecture hall, and we heard a number of presentations, and one of the last presentations was from a retired political science professor there. And he was speaking, and he had a lot of good points. He was very impassioned in his speech, and he said something towards the end like this: "The greatest tragedy will not be for you to select the wrong school. The greatest tragedy is to end up in a job that you hate for the rest of your life. Keep yourself open to possibilities, and may your life's work be something you truly love." And I was wondering in that moment how 17, 18, and 19-year-olds were understanding what this professor said. I know that my daughter is pursuing a career that she loves, but I certainly knew that I understood what this gentleman was saying, because I've said it before and I'll say it again. I feel truly blessed to absolutely love what I do. It's a joy and it's a blessing in my life. And I've also known, it's been a while now, but I've also known jobs that I didn't particularly enjoy so much. So I remember a little bit of what that is like as well. And I also know that it's a reality for some of us that a job is just that. It's a job. It's something to do. It's a paycheck on which to live, and sometimes that is necessary as well. But to do what you absolutely love is a joy and it is a blessing. And I've always thought that there's a difference between a job and a vocation, because a vocation requires more of us than just using the gifts that we have to check off things on a to-do list or a task list. A vocation uses our gifts and uses our talents and uses the desires of our hearts even to impact the community and the world in which we live. Martin Luther, for which the Lutheran Church was named, was the first one 500 years ago to use the word vocation to refer to any type of occupation, not just religious occupations and callings. And behind the term vocation is the notion that every type of work, everything that we can do, is a distinct calling from God. It requires our unique God-given gifts, our skills, and our talents. And moreover, the Reformation doctrine, the movement that Martin Luther founded was the Reformation. Their doctrine of vocation teaches that God himself is active in everyday human labor, family responsibilities, and social interactions. All of those things in the life of faith make up our vocation. And so when Jesus talks about a shepherd, in our gospel reading for today, John chapter 10, I do believe that he's talking about a job about which all of his original hearers would have been familiar. But I also think that Jesus is talking about a shepherd's work here as more than a job. Now, most of us in this day and age, unlike his first hearers, have ever seen a shepherd at work or have experienced one firsthand. But we have some idea of what a shepherd does, don't we? Simply put, it is the shepherd's job to take care of the sheep. The shepherd leads the sheep to places where they can be fed and watered and cared for. He watches over them when they travel from one place to another so that none of them will be lost along the way. The shepherd protects the sheep and watches over them by day and by night. It's a 24-hour job to be a shepherd. And more than that, a shepherd knows his or her sheep. Now, to an untrained eye like mine, all sheep pretty much look the same, don't they? But in the eyes of a shepherd, each one is unique and special. A good shepherd knows the sheep, and in turn, the sheep know their shepherd. And it's interesting to note that sheep will rarely look at the face of a shepherd, but they know their shepherd by voice. They know the shepherd when the shepherd calls out to them and by his or her voice leads them throughout their day. And so Jesus here is offering this wonderful picture of his relationship with us, because when Jesus speaks of the sheepfold, he's speaking to us about our desire for a place where we can belong to something greater than ourselves. He speaks of our desire to belong to a community where we are accepted and loved for who we are. He speaks of our desire to be safe in God's love and to know that we are never lost when we are in the mercy of God. He speaks to us and assures us that we're part of the flock. We're part of the family. He knows us by name. And he calls us as his own forever. And so today, flock, fold, and shepherd are simple words, but they describe our life together and our life with God. And we often, as a church, gather and speak about God's great love for us. But I also think that there are times, actually times for each and every one of us, when deep down we feel as though this promise of God's love and God's care is not for us, but for someone else. Today, I want you to hear the good news, the good word of hope and promise. God loves you. There's no escaping God's love. We can run, we can hide, but God will always find us, and God will always bring us home. Now, I want you to picture yourself doing something now, and I think it's timely. I think we're all looking forward to this. I want you to picture yourself on a beautiful day at the beach. And you're at the beach and you're enjoying the beautiful sunshine. And this is a special sunshine because this is a type of sunshine that isn't going to harm you in any way. It's not going to bake you or burn you. And you are laying on this beautiful beach enjoying the wonderful gift of sun. And then for some reason, you decide that you're going to try to escape the sun or hide from the sun. So you hurry inside, but inside you realize that you're not escaping the sun's warmth. So then you go behind a closed door, but the light of the sun shines through the bottom of the door. You discover that no matter where you go, that sunshine is going to follow you. Well, you may or may not at times try to escape from the sun during these summer months or a day on the beach. But God's love, friends, is not something that we want to try to run away from or try to escape. Actually, you can't. Because God's love is like that special kind of sunshine. It reaches everywhere, and it will never stop reaching you. The good news for us today is that we cannot outrun God's love. No matter who we are, no matter how broken we may feel, God loves us just as we are. No matter what secrets we have, and no matter what aspects of our life we try to hide, we cannot hide from God. We belong to God. And our shepherd knows us for who we are and loves us for who we are. Our shepherd searches us out and finds us. Jesus talks in this reading about the difference between the good shepherd and the hired hand. The hired hand does a job. The good shepherd embraces us and enfolds us. And in another place in Scripture, Jesus tells a story of a shepherd with 100 sheep. One goes missing, and the shepherd leaves the 99 to go out and to search for the one until he finds it. That's not very practical, is it? But that is exactly how God loves us. And God regards us. God will do whatever it takes to find us and to bring us into the fold. Because I believe that our shepherd just loves his job too much to give up on us. But you know, more than that, our shepherd loves us too much and brings to us the mercy and goodness of God every day of our lives. Thanks be to God. Amen.